Let's add some borders and shading to my table. First, I'd like to select a range of cells within my table to apply the formatting. Now I could come out here with my mouse, place it just to the left of the first cell of the table, and I can click and drag to get my eye pointer, and I could pull this down. Another way to do this might be to click in the first cell and then just use your keyboard. I'm going to go ahead and press my home key to move to the beginning of the cell. Then I will hold my shift key, and while holding my shift key, I'll press my right arrow key until it extends all the way across the width that I desire, and then I will press my down arrow key to select the rows that I'm interested in. This might be an easier method using the keyboard than using the mouse to select. Next, since I am on or inside of a table, I can see that I have my Table Tools Contextual tab, and up here at the top I'm going to go ahead and click on Design, and then I'm going to come over here and find the Line Weight tool under the Draw Borders group. I'm going to click the drop down arrow and choose 2¼. Once I've chosen the line weight that I'm interested in, I now have to tell Word where I want to apply that border. So I will come up to the Borders button here inside the Table Styles group, and I will click the drop down arrow, and I'm going to choose Outside. And when I choose Outside, I can see the thick 2¼-inch border applied to the outside box of the table. Next, I'd like to remove the border from my vertical label here so that I see just the text without the border around it. I'm going to go ahead and click in the middle of this cell, and then I will come up under my Draw Borders group, and up here at the top, under the Line Style, I'm going to click the drop-down arrow and choose No Border. Next, I have to tell Word where I want to apply this No Border effect on the given cell. Still inside the cell here, I will come up to the Borders button, click the drop down arrow, and I'm going to choose to take off the top border. I will click the drop down arrow and choose the left border. I will click the drop down arrow and choose the bottom border, and that will remove the bottom left and top border, and I appear here on the left hand side that I just have my label. Next, I'll add some shading to the top row. I'm going to come out here and place my pointer in the top row, and I can just click and drag across if I'd like, or I could use the method before where I click in the first cell, press the home key, hold the shift key, and press the right arrow key, and I can select it discreetly that way as well. Next, I'll choose a shading. So up here in the Design tab under the Table Styles group, under the Shading button, I will click the drop-down arrow and just choose a light green here for my shade. I can apply some shading this left column as well. I will click maybe in my first cell here. I'll go ahead and hold down my shift key, press my down arrow key to just select that first entry, and then I'll give it a shade. I'll come up to the border shading and give it like a light blue. I'd like to show you how to sort a table. So I'll select these cells and come up and under the Layout tab I'll click on Sort, and Word tells me that I can't sort a table that has merged cells, and I have some merged cells inside of this table over here on the left column. So I'm going to go ahead and come out and click on a file that I've had opened recently, and we'll take a look at how to sort this guy. Now, scroll down so you can see the table. I'm going to go ahead and just select this first cell, hold the shift key, and then select the table, but I'm going to go ahead and with these guys selected under the Layout tab, I'm going to come over to Sort, and I'll choose to sort by the first column, and then I'll choose to sort by the second column. So it's going to do a first sort here, and then wherever these are the same, it'll do a subsort over here. I'll click OK, and I come out and I see that I have all of my Californias selected here, and within the Californias I can see that they're sorted alphabetically starting with Los Angeles through San Francisco. And the same thing takes place for New Jersey. If I select New Jersey, I can see that we start with Jersey, Newark, and then Trenton. So we're sorting by the first row and then the second row. Now, you could also come out here and choose to select part of the table to sort. And under the Sort tools, you have the choice of sorting in either ascending or descending order here on these selections for the type. So if we have a numerical date in one of the columns, I would go ahead and tell it that, and then I can choose how I want to sort in ascending or descending order here as well. I could also tell it that my table has a header row or no header row. So if I were to come out here and select the header and the data and go to Sort, I'll tell it it has a header row, and now these guys up at the top will give me the different column headings that I have, and I can just sort by them instead of the different numbered columns that I used in the previous example. Now, subsequently, I could split the table as well. So if I have one table and I want to split it back into two or more tables, I could come out here and do this very simply. I'll come out here where I start the Florida row. I will click on the word Miami, and I will come out and choose to split the table. I could come down and do the same thing for Atlanta. I could split the table. Washington starts. So now I've just taken my large table and split it into several tables based on the state. If I'd like to include the headers that I have on the first table in the subsequent tables, I could select the header, right-click what I have selected, click on Copy, and then come out here, select the first row of the table, and then do a paste to paste the heading. And I can just go ahead and select the first row of each one of these tables and do the same thing. So I can place the header row above the tables as well.